Thank you very much.
No, thank you very much.
Commandant
Tamulo and Lela, the spokesperson of Mkhonto Wesizwe Party. And good afternoon to all the members of the media and to all the people of South Africa and to the ground forces of Mkhonto Wesizwe Party. I want to acknowledge the leadership of the province, of the regions of KwaZulu-Natal and of the National High Command with the officials, the deputy chairs here and the treasurer general and the deputy secretary general. We're going to read out a statement which we will later on circulate for all members of the media to go through, but we're also going to publish that statement in all our social media platforms so that everyone else has got access to that this particular statement. So Mkhonto Wesizwe Party will be marking its first year of existence as a political party on the 16th of December 2024. The first year of the MKP's existence has been defined by many dynamic political and organizational developments and progress. Notable amongst these developments is the fact that in less than 12 months of its existence, Mkhonto Wesizwe is the third largest party in South Africa and the leader of the official opposition in South Africa's parliament. Is the largest political party here in the province of KwaZulu-Natal, the second biggest political party in Mpumalanga province, and is represented in seven of South Africa's nine provincial legislatures. The 16th of December is a very important day in the politics of South Africa because it is historically represented by the fact that the colonial settlers had defeated part of our people. And it is currently designated as Reconciliation Day in South Africa's political calendar. The 16th of December is also an important day in the revolutionary politics of South Africa because Mkhonto Wesizwe, the Liberation Army, was launched on the 16th of December 1961. And because Mkhonto Wesizwe, the party, was launched and publicly announced on the 16th of December 2023, we as Mkhonto Wesizwe Party carry a revolutionary obligation to celebrate and mark the 16th of December as a very important day in the politics and history of our organization. We therefore take this opportunity to publicly announce the following activities and programs to mark the first birthday of Mkhonto Wesizwe Party. The first program will be a public meeting in Gauteng province. The public launch of all the activities to celebrate and mark the first anniversary of Mkhonto Wesizwe will take place in Gauteng province in Ekurhuleni municipality on Saturday, the 30th of November, 2024. We chose Ekurhuleni Metropolitan Municipality because the region demonstrated commendable support to our organization in the 2024 general elections. More than 14% of voters in Ekurhuleni voted for Mkhonto Wesizwe Party, and we're currently the third biggest political party in Ekurhuleni. And we will be the decisive majority and the biggest political party after the 2026 local government elections. We invite the people of Ekurhuleni and the whole of Gauteng province to come in their numbers to support the launching program of Mkhonto Wesizwe first anniversary programs and activities. The public meeting in Ekurhuleni will be addressed by our Commander General, President Jacob Gedleyihlekisa Zuma. The second program will be a public meeting that is going to take place in Mpumalanga province. So the public meeting in Mpumalanga province is going to be held in Mkhondo local municipality in Gertsebande district or the Gertsebande region. And the decision to go to Mkondo local municipality is because in the 2024 general elections, more than 55% of voters in Mkondo municipality in Gert Sibande district in Mpumalanga province voted for Mkondo, which is a party. And that particular program is going to be addressed by our Deputy President, Dr. John Mandlakaise Hlophe. The third program, and that program in Mpumalanga is going to take place on the 1st of December 2024. And then the other program that is taking place on the 1st of December 2024 will be another public meeting that will be addressed here in the province of KwaZulu-Natal by the National Chairperson, Commander Nkosinathi Nhleko. And that program is going to take place in the region of Ilembe, because in the region of Ilembe, more than 50% of the voters of the entire region voted for Mkhonto Wesizwe party. And in three of the local municipalities of Ilembe district, Mkhonto Wesizwe received a decisive majority, that is in Mandeni municipality, in Ndwendwe, in Mapumulo, and in Kwadukuza. Although Mkhonto Wesizwe is number one, it received 40%. So the national chairperson will be addressing a public meeting on behalf of Mkhonto Wesizwe in Ilembe district. And then the main program, the main celebratory program of Mkhonto Wesizwe will be a public rally, which is going to be held on Sunday, the 15th of December 2024, here in Moses Mabhida Stadium, Durban, eThekwini region, in the province of KwaZulu-Natal. So the main rally of Mkhonto Wesizwe's first anniversary program will be here in Moses Mabhida Stadium and will be addressed by our Commander General, President Jacob Zuma. So we chose the region of eThekwini because numerically it contributed the largest number of votes to the votes that overall Mkhonto Wesizwe received in the 2024 general elections. More than 600,000 people here in the city of eThekwini voted for Mkhonto Wesizwe, and the second party after Mkhonto Wesizwe received less than 200,000 votes. So we invite the people of KwaZulu-Natal, the people of South Africa, all ground forces, members of Mkhonto Wesizwe, to come in their numbers to celebrate and mark the first anniversary of Mkhonto Wesizwe, which will take place on Sunday, the 15th of December, 2024. We should indicate that as part of that program, we're going to invite guests, religious leaders, traditional leaders, and other dignitaries who are going to join us for that particular program. We have secured and paid for the stadium, and we are busy with all the logistical issues that are going to define the celebration of Mkhonto Wesizwe's first birthday. And we also are mandated to announce by the Treasurer General that there is 135 hospitality suites here in Moses Mabhida Stadium, and then that we're going to make 85 of those suites available to those who would want to utilize the hospitality services of Moses Mabhida Stadium. And such is going to happen at a fee, which is going to be announced publicly in due course with the details of just what is going to happen in that regard. The other program that we're going to have as the main last program will be a gala dinner that is going to take place on the 16th, which is the actual day of the birthday of Mkhonto Wesizwe. On the 16th of December 2024, Mkhonto Wesizwe party will be holding a gala dinner to be addressed by President Jacob Zuma at the Olive Convention Center here in Durban, Itekwini Municipality. And the gala dinner is going to be attended by invited guests, but by any other person who purchases tables or set of tables to attend on behalf of a collective or as individuals. The details as to how such is going to happen will be announced in due course. We want to take this opportunity to, in conclusion, announce to the people of South Africa that after a long process, and as we had committed in October 2024, Mkhonto we Sizwe has now concluded the process of establishing the headquarters of our organization, which will be in Marshalltown, Central Johannesburg in Gauteng province. And the Durban wing of the head office, because we had said publicly that we're going to have two wings of the head office. The Durban wing of the head office of Mkhonto we Sizwe will be established before the end of December 2024. But the one of Johannesburg, the leadership is going to take occupation before the end of November 2024. So Mkhonto we Sizwe has got the physical head office, all structures and members are going to be informed of where the head office is, and we'll have a press conference there so that those who want to interact with the head office of Mkhonto we Sizwe should be able to come. We also want to make an announcement that after the adoption and public unveiling of our constitution, we have now translated the constitution to all of South Africa's languages. So we have got the Mkhonto we Sizwe constitution in isiZulu, in isiXhosa, in Afrikaans, in Sipedi, in Sisutu, in Xitsonga, in Setswana, in Ndebele, Tshivenda, and in Siswati, so that each and every member of society can be able to gain and read the constitution of Mkhonto we Sizwe. We are going to upload all the language translated versions in the website of Mkhonto we Sizwe. We are also going to physically send the copies to various traditional and religious leaders in the length and breadth of South Africa. In conclusion, we take this opportunity to reaffirm Mkhonto we Sizwe's opposition to the so-called government of national unity, which is nothing but an alliance between the former liberation movement and a political party that represents the descendants and defenders of colonialism and apartheid. Mkhonto we Sizwe represents the best of liberatory politics and agenda, and will work tirelessly to unite all the progressive forces. We therefore reiterate our call for the unification of all progressive and forward-looking political parties and activists. The call for unity is a genuine, revolutionary, honest, and well-intentioned call. We call on all progressive forces to associate with Mkhonto we Sizwe. Like the 1961 generation of freedom fighters who started Mkhonto we Sizwe, the Liberation Army, we too are saying that we are working together in the best interest of the people of this country, black, brown, and white, whose future happiness and well-being cannot be attained without the overthrow of the nationalist government, the nationalist collaborationist government, the abolition of white supremacy, and the winning of liberty, democracy, and full national rights and equality for all the people of this country. We appeal for the support and encouragement of all South Africans who seek the happiness and freedom for the people of this country. Africa, my boy, thank you very much.